You're one, so that's your height, and that's your ear.
Again, if you want, yeah, let's, yeah, go ahead.
Check, check, check one, check two.
Check.
Can you hear me?
Yep, I'm good. You good?
I can't hear you.
You can't hear me?
Try it.
Check, check, check.
Nah, I got you. There we go. Cool. Yep, we're good. We're good there. You get that level?
Yeah, so if you're if you hit that and it illuminates, it mutes your ear.
So this is the crowd.
Okay.
Yeah, if the crowd's too loud, you can bring it down because it'll pick up the ear mics.
Okay.
Yeah. So we'll boost it, you know, in between quarters.
Okay. Cool. Sounds good. All right, good evening, everybody. Welcome to tonight's opening playoff game for your Lady Farmers here in Rowlett, taking on the Lady Vikings from Dallas Pinkston. Brian Brazel joined tonight by Farmersville volunteer extraordinaire, Mr. Nelson Graves.
Good evening, everybody. Thanks for tuning in.
We appreciate Mr. G and Mr. B. They are the only two here from the crew tonight. I had a little sickness run through the normal camera crew.
Yeah, we've...
And so these guys got it all set up by themselves, and they're running everything.
Kind of a ghost crew tonight.
Yeah. So. Well, let's talk about these Lady Farmers. Come in tonight on a three-game winning streak, finished third in the district. Had some really nice wins there at the end of the season. And they're going to take on a Pinkston Lady Vikings team who has won two in a row coming in. Didn't have the best record on the season at 10-23, but they did go 7-3 in district and finish second. And so
it's kind of like the Super Bowl last night. It's not how you start, it's how you finish.
That's exactly right, man.
You
get hot at the right time.
It's exactly right. You know, and looking at, we were watching warm-ups before, got a couple athletes over here to keep their eye on.
Yep.
On Pinkston. Not sure the class level of each player, but there were a few that were warming up that looked like we were just all-around athletes, looked like a couple ballers. So just something to keep an eye out for the Lady Farmers tonight. We're just about ready for tip-off here.
Yeah, looking forward to tonight's game. See what these Lady Farmers come out excited. Got a nice crowd over here in Rowlett.
Yeah, back-to-back first-round appearances for the Lady Farmers from last year and this year. You know, we were talking before the game. It'd be really something cool to see to get them to advance to the next round, you know, especially for senior Rindy Fetty, who's our only senior. We honored her last week as we followed up with the boys on Friday night. So, but, yeah, like you said, ended up the season with a couple good wins there. Play some good games, but we are ready for set tip-off here.
Randy's going to be joined in the starting lineup by Alexia Hernandez. Number 10 is Riley Blankenship. Hernandez takes that ball, sets up the Lady offense with Gally Matthews, along with number 15, Kylie McGee, to start and five for the Lady Farmers. You'll see Hernandez running a lot of points tonight, handles the ball a lot for the Lady Farmers, really gets them in and out of their sets. A little miscommunication there on that turnover.
You know, and you got to think, there's a little bit of nerves here. You know, this is a big step for them. You know, pretty good crowd on both sides for an away game, you know, a neutral site. So, but yeah, just nerves settled in a little bit.
Absolutely. Pass goes out. Shot goes up. Hernandez comes away with the rebound.
You know, just to piggyback on what you said about Hernandez, you know, as a sophomore, Chandler and I were talking about when we honored the seniors, just what an asset she is to the team, whether it's on defense, whether it's on offense, or fast break or whatever, just the leadership coming from an underclassman is a great thing to have when we reload for next year.
That's exactly right. Another turnover there by the Lady Farmers. Lady Vikings look to get into their set. Overthrow there. Randy Fetty comes away with it. Lets everyone clear out. Goes to Hernandez. Does a good job of cutting in front of that one. Goes right down the lane. Shoots a floater. Gets some had a little contact there. Didn't get the foul, though.
Hernandez is definitely not afraid to take it into the lane and go to the hoop. You know, Matthews there, one of our top rebounders. If I was to go back and pull easy body foul there, I think, on Blankenship. But Matthews, if you go back and pull stats for the year, I think offensive rebound, she did a great job the few games that I've been involved in and that I've been at. She's really pulled down some offensive boards and had those second opportunity points there.
Yep. She definitely cleans it up around the glass for sure. First free throw up and no good. And I believe, it looks like that is number one. That is Calhoun Jingles. Is their leading scorer. She's averaging almost 17 points a game. She was actually the leading scorer in district. For their district. So definitely one that you and I kind of saw in pregame we wanted to keep an eye on because you could just tell that she have a nice shot like that, has good rotation, and they're going to be leaning on her a lot tonight. Blankenship comes away with it. A little mini fast break here for the Farmers. Hernandez dribbles her way out of trouble. It's going to reset it.
Yeah, just get a slow down and get in their groove and
down the middle. Yeah, this time she does get the contact. So, again, you talked about her trying to go into the middle of the paint, and she is not afraid, doesn't shy away from contact. The game that I called this year against Quinlan, she had a couple of different and ones where goes in there, gets the contact, and able to finish. I bet we see that tonight as well. So
she did that really good when we visited Caddo here just a couple weeks ago. You know, I think they ended up winning by 20-plus points, and just great domination all over the court. And, again, need to settle in here. She takes that three.
Long three just off the left side of the rim. Rini going for the rebound.
I think they're going to get her for a reach there.
Yeah.
Got her with a push.
So the Vikings be throwing the ball in. Blankenship's going to provide a little bit of little pressure here.
She's fast from side to side.
Yeah.
You know, Chandler and I talked about that last week. She is just zippy all over the court.
Yeah.
She's such a small athlete, but, man, she's fast. You can't see her, you know, as well as somebody like Rindy. But
ball
is tipped out of bounds.
Yeah.
Farmers take possession.
Bounces out of the way. Goes the Lady Farmers way. It looked like, Nelson, I'm going to have to watch this next defensive set here for the Farmers, but it looks like Blankenship is following around number one, Calhoun Jingles, who is their top scorer. Look like they might be running a box in one. I'm going to see if that is exactly what they are.
They
doing.
Ran that when we played Kaufman last Tuesday.
Put her on their
yes.
best scorer and just try to stay in her face a little bit.
Peyton Purser.
Purser.
She just
in
came
now.
In.
Might have picked up that pivot foot, but.
She came in for Matthews, just another freshman.
Yeah.
We talked about underclassmen,
right.
And we'll probably touch on it multiple times tonight, because between Hernandez being a sophomore and Purser being a freshman, your top two scorers, you know, consistently over district.
Sure.
But she's got the height. She's got the ability. She's got the aggressiveness under the boards.
First 3-point shot for the Vikings ends up catching no iron, but they do run down their own rebound. Going to throw it up again off the backboard that time.
Ooh,
good
great
hands
job.
There by Hernandez going in and stealing that one. Goes up to Blankenship. She pulls up for the pull-up three. A little strong on that one, but tipped out by Purser. Hernandez going to launch her own three and then get her
Angel
own rebound.
Gets her own rebound. I love it.
Yeah, and then goes straight up and gets the foul.
There goes that, you know, don't care attitude in regards.
Sure.
I'm gonna take it up. I'm going to make you stop
right.
me. And in that point, she didn't get the basket, but she did get the two free throws, and she's going to go to the line to shoot these.
So, yeah, down here on defense, I did notice Blankenship was following Calhoun Jingles around, and she's left-handed, so she was trying to make her go to the right side, and then once she passed the ball, she just stayed with her wherever she went. So, see how that boxing one works tonight. So far, it's limited her to 1 point. Lady Farmers also looking for their first point of the game, as that first one goes off the rim for Hernandez.
And Jingles just the only other senior on Pinkston's team tonight. So, again, another young class
yep.
for the Dallas ISD team. Same thing with us. The ball's
can't
tipped around.
On the second one. Yeah, it gets tipped out. Two Jingles. Little hesitation and a spin there. Comes up empty. As Purser comes away with the rebound. Goes to Blankenship. So, yeah, it was a fancy-looking move, but didn't catch anything with it.
A lot more shots taken by Pinkston. Like I said, I think they're just trying to score. We need to settle into our game and not so much play against them, but play our game.
Yeah, that's the fourth turnover of this first quarter for the Lady Farmers. That is going to go off of – I think her name might have went off of Hernandez, but, yeah, it did. So the Lady Vikings will be throwing it in under their own goal. 4:53 to play here in this first quarter.
Got to scoot the cheerleaders back just a little
yeah.
bit.
I think the one he's talking to wasn't paying attention. Yeah, now she sees. Okay.
There we go.
Yeah.
Don't step on the Eagles logo.
Yeah. All right.
Jingles kind of gave him a little jingle back there. I said, hey, y'all need to back up. We're trying to get this game going.
McCray checks into the game for the Lady Farmers for the first time tonight. Going to give Blankenship a little breather here. Jingles gets the ball in. Goes up top to number 10. That's night.
I want to say that 24 there at the top of the key was another one of their, just from watching pregame, watching the warmups, was one to keep their eye on here on the bottom
yeah.
side of your screen. And she posts up and takes that shot.
Yeah, takes that. Yeah, and that's the second one. She's definitely not afraid to launch it. That was Spencer on the shot.
Great job by Hernandez
yeah.
as she gets in there.
Comes away with it again. Oh. Just ran up from behind there by number 12, Donaldson. Jingles looking for somewhere to go. Goes out here to Spencer again. Puts it up.
They are not afraid to shoot the big ball.
No, they're not. And nice job there by Kylie McGee of going in against the bigger defender there, but wrestling that ball away and going to call it a tie ball. So it will stay Lady Vikings ball, but good job there by McGee. And there's going to be another one. That's Knight. launches that one, comes away. Spencer gets the rebound down the middle and misses.
I think, yeah, Fetty knocked that out just to kind of break something up. But multiple shot opportunities by Pinkston in the paint.
I don't know what they are from three-point line. It's 0 for, obviously, but it's a bunch. Knight puts that one up from just inside of the three-point line. Lady Farmers still fighting for the rebound. Going to be another, nope, not a tall ball.
Oh, that's a walk then.
Should have been a walk. Nice job there by Rindy, though, of tapping that one out. And then she's going to get out front for
great
the fast
break.
Great
look by Purser.
Yes. Oh, they're going to, oh, I don't know about that. Look like a jump stop.
I don't know. Yeah, I agree. I don't know about the call, but I almost wish you'd take another dribble and just taken that layup and take the momentum was going that way.
Yeah,
let it keep taking you that
it's
way.
It's tough to stop like that, but good job there by Rindy Fetty, though, of tapping that ball away and then getting out front and hustling out in front of everybody. So Jingles brings it across. Looks like Hernandez is going to be on her this time. Spencer thought about it. Goes back to Jingles. Back to Spencer. She's going to shoot it again. Too strong again. Lady Farmers, Hernandez with another backside rebound here.
I think if we can get in our groove down here on offense and get something going, I think it could be a possible
nice take nice there out by Hernandez. Got the contact. Didn't get the foul, though, but Jingles and Hernandez kind of going at each other here. You can see a little.
Well, you've got top scorers. You've got both athletes. They're not afraid to take the ball in. They're not afraid to move the ball. And it looks like they're both the leaders of the team. So, yeah, I mean, they're going to.
McCray goes up with the three and knocks it down. Nice inbounds play there for the Lady Farmers as they get their first basket of the game here.
Again, it just takes that one, you know.
Yeah.
That one shot, that one short run to kind of get that momentum swung the other way.
Just and gets that confidence up for the other girls, too, to take that shot when it's open.
Sure.
Don't have to wait for the perfect one. Just take the open shot.
Another missed three-pointer there.
There's McCray again, and she's got it.
Back-to-back.
Feed the hot girl.
Pinkston's going to take a quick timeout after those both offensive fires from McCray there.
Yeah. Sophomore Caitlin McCray came in.
Man.
And she lit this offense up. 6 points in a matter
just
of about
like
30
that.
Seconds.
30 seconds.
Yeah, absolutely, dude. And so, yeah, you can see a lot of frustration on the Lady Vikings' face. They've shot probably 10 three-pointers.
At least, Brian.
And they haven't made any yet. And we are going to start coming away with some of those 50-50 rebounds. And so far right now, the Vikings are getting some of those back. But, yeah, if you keep knocking down shots like that and adding pressure to a team that is having a hard time finding the hoop.
You know, and Coach Oak, you know, seeing that they have a lot of missed shots and a lot of them are off the board, they're soft rebounds. Get our girls to box out, be ready to accept that shot, and that's an easy rebound.
Yeah, the Lady Vikings.
Take away the offensive rebounds from them.
They've got some size compared to us, and so you're right about putting a body on somebody and really trying to push them away out from under that basket.
Yeah.
Jingles is going to bring it down here as they try to get their offensive set up. Goes to the corner. Another three-point shot put up there.
See, just soft right off the board. They're not even really hitting hard off the rim, but. Was that McGee that got that rebound?
I think it was.
Yeah,
Hernandez
just on that
goes
backside.
Around Jingles. Going looking for McCray again. She's open. She's got it. Almost. Almost had the 3-for-3 there. And she was barely off. And she was feeling it. She was calling
sure,
for the ball.
Sure, why not?
Absolutely.
If it's not broke, don't fix
That's
it.
That's right.
And she wasn't off by much. It was, you know, either way.
Jingles is going to take her shot from the three-point line. Misses it. McCray comes away with the rebound, but
I think her and McGee got kind of tangled up there.
She couldn't control it as she went down. Yeah, you're right. She did bump into her own player there.
Pearson's in for the Lady Farmers.
Yeah.
As Fetty's going to take a little break here.
Another sophomore coming into the game.
As we approach 2 minutes here in the first, your Lady Farmers lead 6-1 against the Pinkston.
Lady Vikings.
Vikings, that's it, yeah.
So 6 minutes gone in this first quarter, and the Lady Vikings shoot one, goes straight out of bounds. So the Farmers going to be throwing it in. Looks like a little full court pressure here for the Vikings. Peyton Purser, though, her defender stayed back, so she'll be the one bringing the ball up. Goes right down the middle. Goes out to McCray. Puts it up. Oh, just off the backside of the iron. But, man, those look good when they leave. When they leave her hand, they look
here.
Good. Yeah, Vikings knock that one out. So the Lady Farmers will be looking for an inbounds play here from Coach Hogue.
I think she gets another half second on either one of those shots. I'm going to take one falls out of the two.
Yeah. Yeah.
She looked just a hair rushed on this one right here. Great
nice.
Look to Purser.
Nice play there. Another nice inbounds play there by the Lady Farmers.
Utilizing Purser's height, she flashes in there. Just a lob from Hernandez right over the top. Should be on the floor. Yeah, going to be baseline.
It's on the floor. He's going to call that against Alexia.
Yeah, she had that hand wrapped around that side. So, you know, I'm almost, Brian, this is just obviously watching 6.5 minutes here with what they've put up or lack thereof. I'm not going to foul. I'm going to make you score. I'm almost going to let you drive. Just that right there. Don't ride them.
Just let them shoot those long three-pointers.
Yeah, she's going to the baseline. There's nowhere for her else to go except out of bounds. So just play the playback.
Right.
Don't ride the hip. And
until somebody starts to make those long threes like this one right here, just let them keep doing it. That was nice.
Great. I was about to say great job on McGee. She did box out. But
ball just slowed down. Didn't go all the way out of bounds. Jingles goes to the elbow. Misses.
Hernandez
nice
able to get that
there.
Rebound.
Yeah. Hernandez with four rebounds already here in this first quarter. Gonna need a little help here. Peyton Purser comes back to help. Jingles doing the same thing to Hernandez. They've got a one-on-one game going on here.
Good spin move there by Purser.
Oh, good job there by Pearson to come away with that one. And Blankenship shoots it. Not able to connect, but Hernandez with her fifth rebound in this first quarter goes out to Purser. That one's a little strong. And then you see
Look at the hustle of Blankenship from the other side of the court.
Yeah, she couldn't. She had so much momentum going, she couldn't stop in time before she went out of bounds. Uh-oh, she might be hurt. Yeah, it looks like she's still down. We can't see anything from here, but the girls are – oh, no, that would be a big loss for the Farmers.
She is pretty shooken up down there just from me standing up to see.
Yeah,
I don't know if she slipped. It's right in front of the water jug.
Yeah.
I can see. You can't see it on our screen.
Well, and you and I mentioned how fast she was going whenever she hit that spot of the floor. So, yeah, there. Unfortunately, there's a lot of bad things that could have happened right there. You're hoping that maybe it's a slip and she hit the floor hard with the
hopefully
something.
It's not a.
Something's not worse than that, you know. So about a little over 7 minutes in here, your Lady Farmers up 8-1, powered by 2 3-pointers from sophomore Caitlin McCray.
Like it might be a knee.
Something on that left foot there, left leg.
Yeah.
Not putting a lot of weight on it, but maybe it's one of those that. Yeah. Getting a little better as she walks a little bit more, right? Or am I just – is that wishful thinking on my part?
No, it looked a little bit, but like I said, I
it's hard to speculate, right? We have no idea what's going on. But
Coach Blaine, our trainers, I'm sure he's going to have her assess it, or he's going to assess it, and that's what he's doing now. Yeah. So, and maybe have her walk some back here out there in the foyer.
Yeah, and it –
But would definitely defensive-wise would definitely be a big loss for the Lady Farmers. You don't want to see any injury of any sort, but –
And that'll put a little pressure, more pressure on Hernandez if she's going to be the one staying on Jingles as they shoot another three. Purser comes away with the rebound, taps it to Pearson. Goes to Hernandez, back to Purser as they're running their fast break. Nice big pass to McGee.
Great job
there by Purser.
Great job by the Lady Farmers as they looked for the avenues, looked for the seams, able to get that ball down there for an easy layup by McGee.
Jingles goes out to Spencer, back to Jingles. Spencer's going to shoot it again. She gets that one. First field goal of the game for the Lady Vikings comes with just about 15 seconds left to play in that first quarter. Great defense by the Lady Farmers. Hernandez looks at the clock. Goes out to Purser. Gets it up. And a little off there.
Just a little bit of mismanagement of the clock. We had that a couple times when I had the last broadcast Tuesday week ago. Just knowing if you've got 10 seconds coming down the court, yes, we have last shot.
Sure.
That's what we want to obtain. We want to retain the last shot, but we want a good shot. If there's 3 seconds left and you have a good shot, take it. Don't wait till a point three to try to force something off-keeled. So.
Well, and it's one of those two. I think there were a lot of people kind of looking at someone else to take the shot, not real sure, you know. And so, you're right. You've just got to have a little confidence there and just be prepared to take it if you got it. So, but as it was,
we got the lead after one.
Good quarter there for the Lady Farmers. Played really well on defense. They took them a little while to get going on offense.
Yeah.
A couple of really nice inbounds plays there, and then a couple of threes by McCray. And you're looking at a 7-point lead here in this opening round playoff game for the Lady Farmers. And again, I think we have seen Pinkston's offense. It's going to be drive and kick.
3 points.
Drive and kick, right? They're going to drive, kick it out, and they're going to keep shooting those threes. And so someone like, you know, Purser and Randy Fetty, our taller girls, are going to – it's coming down to rebounding, right? If we can limit that to one shot and not give them an offensive rebound and get multiple shots, we'll have a really good chance of holding them.
Just kind of an update on Blankenship here. We do see her up walking around at the end of the court by the foyer. Coach Blaine's got her – probably going to get her wrapped up. Yeah, he's got some athletic gauze, athletic tape, going to get her wrapped up. A little bit more stability on that knee as we start the second period here as your Lady Farmers lead 10-3 with a quick turnover.
Yeah, looked like it was a double. Jingles pulls up from just inside of the three-point line and knocks that one down. Big pass up to Peyton Purser. Mini fast break here for the Lady Farmers. She goes right up the middle. Gets the contact and the bucket.
What a drive by Purser. Wow.
That was a great take right there.
Trying not to scream into the mic to destroy the people at home's ears, but, man, that looked like something out of
that was awesome.
The NBA. Just the way she drove, the way she carried herself.
And then finished
as she's going down, she finishes.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Great job. Let her finish off with this free throw.
I was going to say, Spencer comes away with it up to Jingles. Elbow extended, looking for a little room. Tries to take Hernandez. Good defense there by Hernandez, though. Can't get around her.
And I think if you take one out of the picture, which is what Hernandez just did on that possession.
It's their offense, for sure. There's the three.
And make her keep shooting that.
Right, I completely agree, Way off there. Going to be a tie ball.
Well,
should be Lady Vikings. Farmers will have the ball after coming out of the quarter. So, be Vikings ball in their own basket with 7 minutes to play here in this first half. Your Lady Farmers up 12-5.
I think if they can pace themselves and not try to get too carried away, you know, necessarily looking for a blowout, just go out there, win each period. You can't worry about the fourth until you worry about the second.
Yep.
So
I agree.
We won the first one. That's like,
big block there by Peyton Purser. Blocked that one with her elbow and goes up to Purser. She takes it to the hole again, and she gets contact
again. Send her
to
the line.
Absolutely.
They call them free throws for a reason. They're free. Take advantage of it.
She did a great job there. As soon as she received that ball, she took it straight to the floor and went to the goal.
While we've got this moment, we've got Purser's going to shoot these two free throws as she drove in there and got fouled. The Lady Farmers softball starts their season tomorrow. They're finished with tournament play. They will move the game to Salina due to the weather on the field, I believe. That's what I saw that Coach Wolfong had posted. So,
gotcha.
Big shout out. We'll have those streamed tomorrow. I don't know if Coach – is he going to do away games on – I'm not sure.
I'm not sure either.
We'll try to get that answer for you guys. But softball and baseball season is upon us.
And I can't wait.
I'm telling you.
Two free throws there for Purser. Makes it 14-5. Jingles brings it across a little faster than normal. They're trying to get into any kind of offensive set down here, but really it's just been a three-point shooting contest, as that's what Spencer's going to do again.
And I think we're winning the three-point contest.
Yeah, for sure. Hernandez comes away with it. Nice job there pulling that one up. Goes to the hot girl, Purser. Couldn't finish it there. She lost control of it going up.
I think if there was somebody in the lane that she could have flipped that ball back to, would have been a great scenario. But like I said, she's been doing good. She's gotten a foul last two times she's drove. So
that's right. You feed the hot one. Feed that hot hand. Nice rebound there by McCray. Again, limiting them to one long shot. McCray looking for somewhere to go. Goes down the middle. Takes Pearson off the dribble, but
off her
goes
left
off
foot,
of her foot. Yeah. Oh, so they are going to overturn that. Yeah, they overturned it and said it went off the Lady Vikings there. So, Rindy will be throwing this one in. I kind of don't blame the fans over here for being mad. I thought it was off the foot, too. Yeah. Goes to Gally Matthews.
Great pass.
Nice move there by Gally. Oh! Should I was going to say should have been some contact there.
Yeah,
they
I
called
think so,
it late.
It rolled McGee or it rolled Matthew's legs right up from under. Right. So she'll go to the line for two.
Yeah, well, and you know that's kind of one of those calls too. Sometimes the refs maybe subconsciously when they see that the ball doesn't go in, then they blow the whistle. You know, and some if it goes in, they let it go. But it's a foul. It's a foul. So luckily for Matthew, she's going to get a couple of shots here.
And she did a great job shooting free throws last game.
It's a personal roll in.
Yeah, she was able to knock down a handful of the few times she went to the line. So
good.
Just each time we have an opportunity to extend the lead, Lady Farmers need to take advantage of it. Crowd was definitely giving that referee an earful.
Again, I understand.
She fell after the shot. I can see the.
Yeah. We'll see lane violation there against the Lady Farmers, so no shot. So Lady Vikings will be throwing the ball in. I think, yeah, there you go. So I think might need to check that one with the ref. Lady Vikings get it in, go back to Spencer. Over to Jingles, comes away with it.
A little bit of backcourt pressure by the Lady Farmers.
She's trying to get it out of Jingles' hand, I think is what they were doing. Goes back to Jingles at the top, looking for somewhere to go. See, again, if you keep them, if their offense is going to be all outside of this three-point line, and we can do that right there, like we just talked about with using your body, blocking out, come over with the rebound, leave them one shot, then you have a really good chance in this game. McCray.
Great pump
nice
fake by McCray.
There, yeah.
Just couldn't get the roll.
Use that pump fake, though, to get her defender off the ground. Oh, they're going to say Rindy went over the back on that rebound. Mm. Nice job there by the Lady Farmers, though, of giving themselves a couple of different looks, just not able to get it to go down.
15-5 lead your Lady Farmers have as we approach 5 minutes here in the first half.
Jingles looking for somewhere to go. Goes to Spencer. Goes back cross court to Jones. Jingles again. Looks like she wanted to put that one up, and she will this time. And again, way off. So if we can... we can make that their offense.
Sure. Yeah, I think if we can retain and keep them out.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Run that offense outside of that three-point line. We're fine. Peyton Purser goes to Gally Matthews. Back to Purser. Looking for another lane there. Cut off. Hernandez tries to save it from going back court. Vikings come away with it.
Oh, and nice she just job throws there. It right to Matthews.
McCray, I think, knocked that one away from behind. Hernandez got a hand on it as well. Randy Fetty looking for somewhere to go. Goes to McCray. They know that she'll shoot that. Another pump fake there for McCray. Goes down the lane. And again, a delayed call
delayed
there.
Delayed call, but.
I think it's one of those, again, it didn't go in. And so they.
My whistle wasn't working, or I would have called it first.
Yeah. Again, if it's a foul, it's a foul. But as it is, McCray will go to the free throw line. Put two up. Give the Lady Farmers a chance to catch their breath a little bit here. First one's up. Rolls it in. Extends it out to an 11-point lead as we're about halfway through this second quarter. A little over 4 minutes to play in the first half.
What do they say? If it doesn't matter if it swishes or if it rolls around and falls in, it still counts.
That's right. Referees getting together and talking a little bit. Looks like they're going to go to the scorer's table and verify a few things. Maybe...
I think they're maybe verifying who the foul was
on. That's exactly what I was going
to say. Whether it's 23 or 30, but they've got it up there as 24 right now.
And I think you're right. And let's see. I think they're going to leave it. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
Which is her second foul of the game.
And I could see the coach trying to, you know, hey, are you sure it was on the right one? Because Spencer is her second leading scorer. And we've seen her throw up some threes tonight. So second one from McCray bounces off. Looks like it's going to be knocked out of bounds by Purser there, though.
She was battling 34 there, and I think she just longer-armed was able to
just
last one to touch it. Yeah,
had the last hand on it. Nice defense on Jingles. She goes out to Spencer, shoots that one off of her knee. Good defense there by the Farmers as Rindy Fetty comes away with the rebound. Hernandez looking to push the pace here. Nice pass to Gally Matthews.
Oh, I thought it was going out.
Oh, and then McCray with the steal of her own goes up and another foul.
I don't know why they would argue that call. It was blatant.
Yeah,
that was a foul. That
definitely looked like a foul to me. That'll put McCray back to the free throw line where she just hit one out of two. Banks that one in.
It'll work.
And looks like that is going to put the Lady Farmers in the bonus for the rest of this quarter. Yeah.
That new rule change this year, mm-hmm. we get to five team fouls a period. Yep. It automatically goes to a double shot instead of the one and one.
Yep. And she knocks them both down. Extends it out to a 13-point lead here for these Lady Farmers. So we're halfway through this second quarter. It's gone pretty quick.
You know, when you get to this point in the game, you know, you've scored 5 points in a period and a half.
Oh, Hernandez.
The frustrations. I mean, she poked a hand in there and just knocked it out. You know, she's all over the court as we're talking about Blankenship not being in the game. She is wrapped up really good from our viewpoint. Going to get her shoe back on. But the Lady Farmers have stepped up since the speed of Blankenship has been out of the game.
Yep. No, completely agree. Hernandez doing a really good job just anticipating. They know that they want to take the ball back to Jingles when they can. Spencer with another three. Nice job there by Matthews to come away with that rebound. Spencer went down on that. That doesn't look good.
And I know the fans are frustrated that they're not stopping the game, but once they get to a stopping point, now they can stop the game.
Yeah, they can't call an injury timeout in the middle of a live ball, unfortunately.
Correct. And I know that they – that seems unfortunate at times, but
it's just a rule.
It is.
Unfortunately. Now, if you
and it goes both ways.
Yes. If your team has it and you have a player hurt, you take your time out there. But, yeah, she.
I don't know if when.
A little bit of pain there.
I think when Matthews was clearing that rebound, which is what we're taught, you know, not to throw an elbow, but you stick your arms out to clear that lane. And that really, I think, also the reason you.
Looks like
might have caught her in the face.
Side of the neck or the face there. He's checking her right there, left side of her neck. But no, I agree with you. I think it's exactly what happened is because they're both going out at the same time.
Sure.
And your first inclination is to protect the ball.
Well,
we're taught to protect it by.
At a young age.
Yeah, absolutely.
We teach you to get those arms out. So if you see a defender trying to reach over the arms, it's easier to kind of get them to foul you.
Sure.
So nothing intentional from what I saw.
Oh,
I don't think
not.
Just an aggressive play. You know, give her a round of applause for. Yeah. Being able to get up on her own and walk off the court. And what if she caught it in the eye, kind of.
Yeah.
But that is their second leading scorer.
That will be she'll have a bruise there for sure because they were getting after it down there. Been a hard-played game.
24,
sides.
Right?
Yep. Yep, Spencer averaging a little over 10 points a game. So second leading scorer for the Lady Vikings. So Vikings bringing across. Jingles looking for somewhere to go. She's going to take a step back three, and she hits it. Now she's one of those players that you just don't want to let her get hot because she is averaging 17 points a game. Oh, just off of the hands of Purser there. And good defense by McCray.
Great job by McCray.
Comes from behind and knocks it away. Hernandez looking to push it. He's going to slow it down here and let those Lady Farmers get into an offensive set. Bounce pass to Purser, who goes right down the middle looking for somewhere to go. McCray's going to put the three up off the front of the rim. Oh, they're going to call that a travel, but that's an unfortunate.
And they don't like the call, but she did
That
move
is the
her
rule.
Feet.
Yeah, that is the rule, unfortunately. So Lady Farmers have had a couple of nice little inbounds plays here. Let's see what they're able to do here with 2:40 to play in this first half up by 10.
My favorite one is this one right here.
Nice. Good job. Purser not able to get it to go, but does draw the foul. So she'll get a couple of more free throws here. Lady Farmers have had a lot of free throw opportunities here in the second quarter, and that just comes from being aggressive with the ball, taking the ball straight up when you get a chance.
Again, any opportunity you have to go up with the ball, look to make that shot, but if not, the way they've been playing, they're going to foul you. So I'm going to be more aggressive in the paint.
First one goes down for Purser. Another substitution here for the Vikings as Donaldson checks in for the first time tonight. Second one up and rattles in. Nice job there by Purser, knocking down both of those, extending this lead out to 12, 20-8. As Jingles brings the ball across, definitely pushing the pace here for herself, looking for an open shot, goes the left-handed floater. Not able to connect, but the Vikings do come away with it.
Has she got all? Ooh, has she got all of their points this evening?
I don't remember.
Or did that number 10 right there have a 3-point earlier?
Yeah, one of those girls made a shot. Now looks like that's the third foul on Rindy. So Rindy, a little frustration as she's coming out because again, none of those fouls have been real
aggressive or obvious.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, almost kind of a touch and go foul.
Sure. Yeah, they've been some touchy fouls for sure. Way off there by Knight as Purser brings it down, brings it across, looking ahead for Hernandez. Goes back to Purser. Had a three. Goes down the lane. Puts it up. But
great
nice
job by
there
McGee.
By McGee. Puts it up and in.
Great offensive rebound. We talked about that earlier. Yeah. The second opportunity shots. If you can give those to you.
Get it up quick.
Sure. As they extend their lead 22-8 as we just approach 2 minutes here left in the first half.
Vikings come away with that rebound off the three. Go out to Jingles. Puts it up off the back iron. Good job there by McCrea clearing that one out.
I just say let them keep shooting them and prepare for the rebound.
Completely agree.
That would be my defensive strategy, basically.
Everyone stand just on the three-point line and let them have all they want. Oh, that's going to be a walk.
Did. She did. One dribble on the ground as she backs up.
Yep. It's almost like she lost her balance.
She did, almost like a stumble backwards.
Yeah. Minute and a half to play here in the first half. Lady Farmers looking to protect this 14-point lead. Jingles brings it across. Nice defense there by the Farmers. Keep her out of the lane. She still looks to go left. Loves that left side. Left-handed right there.
Ooh, fast break.
Yeah, Matthews comes away with it to Hernandez. Yeah, she had a hard time corralling that ball in, but the Lady Vikings knocked it away. So the Lady Farmers will be throwing it in with 1:09 to play here in this first half. Coach B sending in the play. Coach Ho giving a little motivation to make sure they know where they need to be. Oh, nice. Right there to Purser. Not able to connect, but Hernandez runs it down. Saves it
great
in
job.
Back to Purser.
Oh, nice pass little, by Purser. Yeah. She goes behind the back.
Little no look there to Hernandez. That should have been a double. Yeah. Yeah. 56.9 seconds to play here in the first half. Your Lady Farmers looked really good so far. This first-round playoff game against the Lady Vikings from Pinkston. Jingles is letting the clock run down a little bit here. Goes to her right side. Knight fakes the three. Comes up a little short. Gets her own rebound. Puts it up. Not able to go, but she did get fouled.
Is that there? I think this is their first. Is this the first shooting? No, because they got their first point scored on.
Yeah, on a free throw.
On a free throw, yeah.
They haven't had a lot. Well, and again, when you shoot three-pointers, you're not going to get fouled that
Yeah, you're
times,
not going to get fouled right? a lot. We're letting you guys
Unless
shoot them.
Unless you're Steph Curry, who seems like he gets fouled on every other one that he shoots. Knight puts it up and bounces that one home. One more free throw here for Knight. 40 seconds to play in the first half. Able to connect on that one. Cuts
Looks
it back
like
down to a 12-point lead.
Bring their offense maybe into the paint a little bit.
Yeah. Hernandez does a good job of getting around Jingles. Jingles met a Gally Matthews screen.
And it worked like it's supposed to.
Couldn't get past it. Nice job there by McCrea. Backside rebound puts it up and in.
The Pinkston bench wanted to, and the crowd wanted a foul, but
she was sitting there the whole time. That
was
perfectly legal and clean.
Hernandez
screen.
Did yeah. her job seeming right
yes.
off of the hip.
Yes. Goes off of the face
of
there.
Of Matthews. Look up.
Look up to Peyton Purser. 2 seconds. She gets it.
Great job.
Nice job there by the Lady Farmers. Push that one up. Finish on a fast break.
What a finish.
And they go up 26-10 after the first half here against the Lady Vikings from Pinkston.
You know, to touch on what I said earlier, you know, it's not how you start, it's how you finish. We right. had a really, really slow,
sure.
sluggish got to get in our groove first period, and then I would like to see first to second what we were able to put up. I mean, that was just a fast break. Had some good threes by McGee or McRae.
4.5 minutes to get our first point of the game, and then since then, I mean, they've really found their rhythm. So we're going to take a quick break here during halftime. We'll be back shortly, bring you guys the third quarter, so stay with us.
Where's that mic? Okay, we were just looking.
right, welcome back, everybody. Getting ready to bring y'all the third quarter of tonight's opening round playoff game for these Lady Farmers against the Lady Pinkston, or the Lady Vikings of Pinkston. And Nelson, I'd say, again, we talked about this as we went into halftime, but that slow start for the Lady Farmers, they continued to fight. They still hustled everywhere on the court. They were knocking, you know, passes away, deflecting stuff, and they finally started making some shots, and they were able to finish on a nice little run there and take it from a 12-point lead up to a 16-point lead.
You know, Brian, that's right. They didn't change anything. And just to touch on real quick, Blankenship, who went out for the knee injury early in the second period, she's going to be back in. We were just talking about that. We saw her run from the locker room back in. So Coach O's going to have her back in there.
Yeah, just give her a go here, see how she feels, yeah.
You know, they had that slow start. They didn't change anything. Right. They just executed better. Yeah. There's nothing wrong with what you're doing. Just do it better.
Just trust it in the process.
And I think if they keep that gas pedal on a cruise control now and just keep playing their game as Hernandez dishes off.
Nice play there. Oh,
Matthew's able to get her.
Yeah, got her own rebound there. Tied up. Will be Vikings ball. But I do like seeing that because we've seen Hernandez get into the lane a little bit, but most of her passes have been out to the side. And that time she was able to get really deep in the lane and get it to Galley close to the basket. So
and I would have her do that 10 times out of 10 than to try to force.
I think speaking that's of one force, of yeah, speaking of forcing, Jingles there threw that floater up, came up
I
short.
I think that's the first time she's really taken the ball interior
tried
this
to.
Evening.
Hernandez looking for somewhere to go. It looks like the nice
backdoor
cut there by Peyton Purser. Oh, just not able to finish. And then the Lady
she
Farmers
was looking for
her.
She paused, and then she was still able to get it to her. And I think if it was, you know, she finished with her right hand. I think she finished with her left hand. She had a better angle on the backboard.
Too good look there for the Lady Farmers. Her first two times down, not able to connect. But you do like that their offense is working the way they want it to. Knight puts up the three there for the Vikings. Knocked away by Purser, and then Hernandez gets it. That's going to be a foul on 10. Number 10, that's Knight. And they did. The Vikings got into foul trouble there in that second quarter as Lady Farmers able to get into the bonus about halfway through the quarter. So,
and we were able to take advantage of some fouls and some free throws made to extend our lead.
Oh, got a little snowbird here as Blankenship peeled out of that. That was a really nice play there. Hernandez letting her Lady Farmers get set. Takes Jingles off the dribble, goes to Purser. Nice little one-handed runner there, not able to get it to go, looking for some contact. Doesn't get the foul there. Ball goes out of bounds. Might have forced that one a little bit as until Peyton was a little frustrated there after that shot.
Yeah, just not able to get those first two that she's had opportunities inside the lane as that three goes up.
Quick shot there by the – and that was Spencer there, just grimacing. She's the one that got hurt as well in that first half for the Vikings. Hernandez looking to get around Jingles and does. Not able to finish, though. But a good job of taking that around. And then, again, kind of anticipating that they're going to go back to Jingles with it.
You know, first few possessions there for the Lady Farmers. They've driven interior and had some great looks and some great passes.
Jingles, little sidestep three right there. Able to get that one to go. And again, she's one of those you don't want to let her get hot, obviously.
Sure.
Scored a lot of points this year. You don't want her to get that confidence. Yeah. Hernandez had that one stick to her hip a little bit. Got her hand under it.
Little intensity there from the Pinkston Vikings.
Yeah. Hernandez getting a little frustrated too. She came up talking to the bench after that one. Oh, wow. Knight able to get that one to
bounce around there.
To bounce in. Now, this is the one thing about teams that shoot threes is they can eat into a lead really, really quickly if they get hot.
Sure.
It's just, that's going to be a foul on Jingles. It's if they get hot. They haven't been hot the whole game. Now, they've made two their last two times down, and those 6 points add up quick, but Lady Farmers got to continue to play good defense. Just give them one chance. Don't let them get any offensive rebounds.
And as a team, you've got to have more of an offensive strategy than just, hey, if we shoot 33s and we make four, you know.
And that's pretty much been their MO this game. Hernandez goes in. That's going to be another foul by Jingles.
I don't know what she was throwing her arms before. She had two hands on Hernandez. That's
the third one on Jingles.
Jingles, yeah.
And I tell you what, that is somebody they absolutely cannot afford to lose.
You know, we talked about team fouls. They're already at three.
with not even 3 minutes. I mean, we're just over 2 minutes of play here in the third period.
Let's talk about Coach Hogan, her strategy tonight, and what we've seen. So they box and one in that first half to put pressure on Jingles. And now what they're doing is with Hernandez is they're having her go to the hole as much as she can because Jingles is guarding her. And what's happened is there's been two quick fouls now. They're putting that pressure on her. Love Coach Hogan's strategy because it's definitely paying off. Hernandez able to get that first free throw, bump it back up to an 11-point lead. Nice high arc and free throw, able to roll it in. So 12-point lead here for the Lady Farmers as Jingles brings it down, looking for somewhere to go. Goes out to Spencer, gets it down low. Going to call a foul there. Maybe on Hernandez?
I think it's on Hernandez.
And I only said number 21. No. Or 12.
Or 12.
That's okay. Yeah.
And Purser looked around at that timeout as Coach called the timeout.
Yeah.
And the table announcer here at Rowlett said the personal foul was – Peyton Purser, and she looked around like I wasn't even close. I wasn't even on that side of the block. So
timeout here. I couldn't tell who that was by. Might have been by the
Vikings. It was on Coach.
Was it Coach
Hogue? Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I think she wants to talk to Hernandez. We talked about Hernandez is getting a little frustrated out there. You can tell. She's a little more animated. And so Coach Hogue wanted to pull her aside, visit with her, and remind her.
Yeah, get her to reset.
Yeah,
play
absolutely.
Your game. Don't let them determine how you play. Let them play to you.
So that will be number 12, Lyric Donaldson, shooting free throws for the Lady Vikings out of the timeout. Again, 2 3-pointers here in this third quarter for the Vikings. Cut it down to a 10-point lead, but
those two shots is more than half of what they scored in the first half.
For sure. Yeah, and Hernandez made the free throws, put us back up by 12. But I agree, if you can just limit them to just 1 3-point attempt per possession, you'll be okay. Just can't give them 2 or 3 on those offensive rebounds. First one in for Donaldson. Makes it 28-17. Farmer fans created a little noise down there. No,
unable to hit the rim on that shot.
No iron on that one. So that will go to the Lady Farmers as it looks like they're going to run their inbounds play again. Yep, they run the Snowbird again, and she's open. Gally Matthews runs it down to Hernandez. Goes right down the middle again. Nice
great
pass.
Feed.
Great pass to Gally. Not able to get it to finish. But a really nice wraparound pass there by Hernandez. She went right around Jingles that time. Jingles able to go down there and, oh, gets the left-handed floater to go on the right side. That's a tough shot, but able to get that one in. Makes it a 9-point game here with 5 minutes to play in the third. Hernandez looking for somewhere to go. Has a screen up top. Has a double screen.
She was looking for a shoot.
Goes to Gally Matthews. Puts it down. Oh. Couldn't tell if she lost control or maybe it got tipped, but not able to finish on that one. She goes to Spencer, and Spencer has a layup.
Definite momentum change here in these first few minutes as we approach 4 minutes in the third.
Coach Hogue is going into the bench. He's going to get a couple of new bodies out there here at the next dead ball. Hernandez, nice screen there. She goes around that. Not able to finish. Gally Matthews with a good job. Oh, man. A lot of contact in there, but not calling anything. Good job there by Peyton Purser going down and tying that one up. That's going to be Lady Farmer ball. Yeah, lots of contact there, and Gally's been right in the middle of it. She's just not getting any calls.
Yeah, she's not. I just, if that ball changes direction like that drastically, and she basically changes body direction, it's more than just a tip.
Yeah. McGee and Blankenship are going to get a little breather here as that was McCray and Rindy Fetty checking back in. Bounce pass in.
She had the lane, just unable to control the ball there.
Not able to pull that one in. That one gets pushed up tonight. And she barely misses that one. It looked good coming off. Yeah, that looked like a big push there. Randy Fetty running the break to McCray. Going to be another foul, so McCray will get some free throws here. But Lady Farmers have had a lot of chances right there from within 5 or 6 feet. Just haven't been able to finish them yet.
The same thing on that right there.
And it's the same thing happened in the first half, right? You had that slow start, couldn't get them to go, and then you get that rhythm. You just got to keep forcing it, keep putting those shots up. They're going to start going in here in a second, just like they did in that first half. First free throw was off there by McCray as the Lady Vikings make a substitution. Second shot up. Off the front.
Great
nice
job by Purser.
There by Purser. Gets the foul.
She's going to call a travel.
I heard the whistle, and I thought it was because of the foul, but he said it was the travel. Wow. Still doesn't take away from the fact that was a great play by Purser.
Yeah.
So Jingles is going to bring the ball up quick, looking for somewhere to go. Goes to the left wing. Three-pointer is way off, but not able to corral that one before it goes out of bounds. That should have been a walk right there.
Oh,
he's gonna override him right here. Watch. He's gonna talk.
No, he's not.
Oh man, that's a bad call because that's the four on Rindy.
Man.
Yeah, that's four on Rindy. That's a tough one, man. I don't believe that was a foul. We'll swing it around. Another 3-point attempt. Nice defense.
Rindy's gotta be careful down there.
Oh wow. Body's on the ground. Purser comes away with it. Oh, what a pass. What a pass by Peyton Purser from her knee.
Great
job.
Gally
Matthews goes ahead to Hernandez. That was a heck of a play by Peyton. That's athletic right there. Jingles comes back down, shoots a three. She's going to be off. Another backside rebound there for the Vikings as Jingles looking for a little more space again. Extended defense out on her. Over to Jones, kicks it over to Knight, puts it up. Again, they're getting too many offensive rebounds, but Galley comes away with that one. Oh, she's stripped from behind. And these Lady Farmers are all over it, man. Going to calm it down a little bit here, but boy, there are bodies flying all over the floor here in this third quarter. Nice job there by Peyton. Gets it over Hernandez. Going to let everybody get set up here. She has her offense running around, getting into their spots. Nice take by Peyton. They're going to call a tie ball there. That's going to go to the Lady Vikings. So, Lady Farmers is kind of out of rhythm right now on offense. Kind of a lot of standing around looking at each other. And it's, a part of it's just been because of the lack of calls, and there's just some frustration you can see that's building out there on the faces of the Farmers. And so it's going to take one of those deep breaths and get back into your offensive set. Speaking of offense, here comes Jingles at a full run again. Kicks it out. Three is up. Comes up short. Nice job there by Rindy Fetty. Comes away with the rebound.
Perfect job to clear it out.
Yeah. Again, limit them to one shot. You're going to be okay. Nice job by Purser. Goes to McCray. Nice little dribble take there. Oh, not able to finish, though. Lady Vikings looking to push. Up to Jones. One of the three, but lost it. Goes back to Jingles around the left side. Nice little dump pass.
I think he's going to call it on Matthews, but she was straight.
She did.
Up.
She was literally standing there with her hands up, and they just jumped into her.
That's only her third team foul for the Lady Farmers here in the third.
Yep. So one more team foul on the Vikings will put us in the bonus, and it'd be nice to get back to that free throw line.
Yeah.
Where we were able to take advantage there in that second quarter. The first one rolls in, makes it 30-22 with less than 2 minutes to play here in this third quarter as Pearson checks in for the Lady Farmers. And it looks like Vikings trying to get their player in, but too late. Have to wait till the next dead ball as that one was missed. Purser comes away with it. Big pass up to McCray. Nice take by McCray. It goes in, goes to Matthews. Nice take by Galley. Oh, just
sure
don't get the
that
foul. My goodness. She got hit both sides there. No foul.
And it goes back to what you said. That's where the frustration sitting in. I don't know where that wasn't a foul, but that
good
air
defense
ball
there by Hernandez as Purser comes up, tries to make the big pass, but there's McCray to get the deflection, and she takes it all the way in, just not able to finish. Jingles goes the other way for the Vikings. Nice pass down low.
That's going to be on Matthews with the body, but she didn't get a free.
Yeah, she didn't give him a free one there. Could've.
Matthews only got three fouls on her. That puts us at 14 fouls, but, man, she had an open shot. So
yeah.
She didn't have that free shot. Now she's got to shoot two free throws. Looks like Coach Hogue's going to put in Kyla McGee after this first shot.
Now, Galley has been very active in this third quarter, but, man, it's just been a lot of contact where she's at. She's just not getting those calls. But with three fouls, you're right. Don't want to take a chance of getting that fourth in this third quarter.
And then Spencer's coming in for the Lady Vikings.
And Kylie McGee's played a good game tonight
she
as
has.
Well. She's done a really good job of blocking out and coming away with some rebounds.
Ooh.
Oh, just not able to get that one to go. Nice job there by McCray. Not able to control it, though, as she and Hernandez racing after it. So the Vikings will maintain possession after missing both free throws. Jingles to throw it in. Yeah, he's got to watch the person who throws it in. They like to try to go back to him. Oh,
loose
ball is loose. McCray runs it down for the Lady Farmers. Goes straight to the hoop with it. Love that. And gets the foul.
Great job.
Nice
finally
job there
the
by
ball
McCray. Yeah. They've continued to be aggressive and go straight to the hoop, and right there it paid off for her. That hustle to run the ball down, and then she literally had no hesitation, went straight in and got the foul. Free throws up.
Short.
A little short there. Hernandez comes away with the rebound. Minute to play here in this third quarter. Jingles brings it over, looking for somewhere to go. Nice defense there by Hernandez. She puts up on a really awkward three-pointer, hits nothing.
That wasn't a foul. She had already came down and moved back.
She was just moving awkwardly to her left and just lost her balance there when she hit the ground. Under 50 seconds to play. Hernandez looking to take. Jingles off the dribble. Goes, nice pass to Purser, goes to that right side, just loses the ball on the way up, though. We're going to call that a jump ball, fortunately.
Yeah. Lady Farmer should retain possession underneath the goal.
Yeah, that should be their ball, and it is. Coach B sends in the inbounds play. McCray's open for the three. She puts it up just off the backside of the iron. Oh. And Purser knocks it away from Ooh. Milo. They're going to call a foul on that.
I thought Purser came up from underneath and got that ball.
I did, too. But that will put them in the
bonus
now.
We're already in the bonus.
Yep. So the last 30 seconds of this quarter, both teams in the bonus. Farmersville again nursing that 10-point lead. Blankenship looking to check in here for the Lady Farmers.
And Berea.
Yeah. Looks like Whoopi Berea is going to be checking in for the first time, too, here. Give McCray a little break.
You've got a lead. You've got fresh legs.
Yep.
We don't need to change anything that we've done. We just need to do what we've been doing in the second period better. Back to that.
Give McCray and Purser a chance to catch their breath here as we get ready to get into this fourth quarter.
Yeah, Purser hasn't been a starter, but, man, when she comes off the bench, her off-the-bench points are killer.
And she brings a lot of energy.
She does.
Hernandez comes away with the rebound. Gets a little backcourt pressure here by Jingles. Lady Farmers looking for a shot here with 20. Oh, Blankenship backs up for the three. Oh, almost knocked it down. They let that one go out of bounds. So 14.3 seconds here. They're going to put a little backcourt pressure on just to not let Jingles have a chance to give Jingles a chance to get going for this last shot. 10 seconds. 7, 6, 5. Jingles does get through there. Dumps it out. Oh, that's going to go. It was saved,
off Pearson's leg.
Saved but thrown off of a Lady Farmer leg there. So with 2.1 seconds to play here, the Pinkston coach is going to use her 20-second timeout. She's going to try to put together an inbounds play here that will almost ultimately end up in a three-point shot for somebody because
it's going to have to be a quick shot. You're going to have to get the ball in, get set, put up a shot before that clock goes off.
Yep. You know, Lady Farmers started this quarter up by 16, still up by 10. As they've had to, there have been a couple of periods of momentum where it's gone over to that Lady Vikings sideline, and Lady Farmers continue to fight through it, absolutely have hustled the whole game, every player that's been out there. So they've definitely earned this 10-point lead so far. Let's see if they're able to do here in this last 2 seconds. So Jingles will be throwing the ball in. Surprising. Go out to Pearson, or Spencer, I'm sorry. Puts it up.
Airballs that shot as we end the third.
Yeah.
Seen a lot of those tonight.
Been a lot. So after three full quarters here in Rowlett, your Lady Farmers have a 10-point lead, 32-22, as we get ready to go into this fourth quarter here.
We definitely have the opportunity to close this game out. You know, even the way that third period went, the momentum definitely shifted.
Yep.
To Pinkston there, the few minutes, you know, they went back to shooting the threes. They were able to knock some down. Well, you take away those two threes, we're back to the 16-point lead.
Well, and it really the momentum came from two things. Number one, those two threes that they haven't been able to put together all night long.
And no calls.
It was missed calls where lots of contact. And I'm not going to say that they got every call, but we didn't get any calls.
We didn't get any. When Matthews flails to the floor.
Right, yeah.
And a complete body change.
When she's shooting the ball, then, there was probably some contact there. And so, again.
Which they were apt to call that in the first half.
Right. And the refs have been, they were consistent in the first half. And they, they did miss a few there. I agree, sometimes you got to let them play. But when a foul is committed, you got to call the foul. So, fourth quarter underway. Jingles looking for somewhere to go. Nice defense there by Barrera. Keeps her extended outside. Off tonight. Three-pointer not able to run down her own miss there as it goes out of bounds. And so Lady Farmers be throwing this one in. Again, you got Blankenship, Hernandez, McGee, Pearson, and Barrera on the floor for the Farmers. Smaller lineup here.
Yeah, a lot of fresh legs for the Lady Farmers.
Nice inbounds play there as that got Hernandez on the run. Step back. Not able to get that to go. But another nice inbounds play there by Coach Hogue. Jingles definitely goes tonight.
And I'm not opposed.
The three-point line. Nice job there by Blankenship of blocking out a much taller player and coming away with the rebound. That's just basketball IQ right there.
You don't see a lot of boxing out nowadays. You see a lot of shooting and then falling back.
Yes.
Nobody follows their shot, you know, from the days of old.
Some of those old fundamentals we were taught over and over and over. Hernandez with the ball on her hip, looking for somewhere to go. A lot of movement down low. Oh, stepped right in front of that pass. So Jingles comes away with it. Hustled there by Barrera to get back in front of her. Going to call that.
Ooh, I thought Jingles dropped that shoulder.
They were
going
to call it in continuation, but, it sure looked like she was trying to lean into that one, didn't it? So the bucket by Jingles cuts it to an 8-point lead, and she gets one free throw here. Coach Hogue taking a look at a couple of her post players, and, she talked to them. She's going to put them back in as Rennie Fetty and Peyton Purser looking to check in. They check in for Pearson and McGee.
You don't know, with Rindy being in foul trouble, you don't want her to sit out the whole period of her senior
right, yeah. Yeah, I know.
Playoff game.
But she's got four fouls, and so, you've got to be careful there, too. So not a great position for Rindy, but she's a smart, smart player, has been every sport she's played for as long as she's played. Yeah, she got tied up on the way in. That was not a walk. No.
They're wanting travel. The reason that it wasn't is because there was possession by both teams at the same time.
Yeah, when she tried to jump stop and they grabbed the ball, and the crowd didn't see that. But when she came back down, it looked like she just jumped, but she didn't. So Lady Farmers are going to throw it under their own goal here. Again, down to a 7-point lead. Randy gets it, surveys the scene, goes to Hernandez down low. Reverse pivot, shoots from the free throw line, extended, not able to finish, but Purser gets the rebound and takes it up. Nice job there by Peyton Purser. Cleans up that shot, makes it a 9-point lead as we get to 6.5 minutes to play here in the game. Barrera in there to play some defense on Jingles. Jingles puts it up over Barrera, but misses. Another nice rebound there by Blankenship. And if we can continue to limit them to long attempts, Blankenship zigzags her way down the court, goes to Barrera. Barrera out to Purser, goes around her player. Rindy from the baseline, just off a little bit. That's a weak call.
That was a weak foul.
She just fell down when she caught it. So that's going to be three on Peyton.
And we're already up to two team fouls this period, and none for the Vikings.
McCray checks back in for Barrera. And Blankenship out there flexing that knee, getting ready to play some defense here on Jingle. Goes out to Knight. Knight takes it inside of the three-point line. Can't finish. Vikings came away with the rebound. Oh, and they come away with another one. Can't finish again. Oh, nice job there by Purser. Goes up, blocks the shot, and then ties it up. Nice job there by Peyton Purser, because they had really good positioning, the Lady Vikings did, as they were just kind of playing catch over the rim there, and Peyton stepped in.
Too many opportunities for second shots, though, in that possession.
I agree completely. Oh, that's going to be a foul on Hernandez. I think that's only her second. Yeah, it is. But it is the third team foul.
Because they called that other one on Purser when we thought it was Hernandez.
Yeah, Knight from just inside of the three-point line misses that one badly. McCray comes away with it. And that should have been a foul, too. Nice job there by Hernandez. Man, look at this scrum here. Oh,
but they're
going to
call
on
that from across the court.
Yeah, that's a bad call. I'm trying not to be too critical, but that's a bad call. He just completely missed that one. If he makes the call, the right call, they don't get into that situation.
Sure.
Yeah, that's just a bad call. 5.5 minutes to play in the game, Lady Farmers. Trying to protect this 9-point lead. Jingles goes over to Spencer. She puts it up, long three-pointer. Actually able to hit one that time.
A broken clock's right twice a day.
I know. 6-point lead. Hernandez gets around Jingles. Bounces out to McCray, who goes right down the lane. Out to Blankenship, open three. And then, just off the back side of the iron. Nice offensive set there for the Farmers.
The shot looked good. She was open. That's a
shot
that
we've seen Blankenship make a bunch of those this year. That's a shot.
I don't like that shot.
No, you'll take that open shot anytime you get it. Spencer again, who just made the three. It's McCray able to get out on her, not give her any space. And you see Blankenship, who's just keeping the ball away from Jingle. Spencer got hot, made another one. Cuts it all the way down to a three-point lead here. You live and die by the three, and right now they're living by it. Hernandez talking to her offensive girls here as they get into their set. Goes right down the lane. Nice little take there by Hernandez. Quiets this
Great
Pinkston
job
crowd.
By Hernandez.
Absolutely.
Plays basketball, takes it to the lane, crossover dribble.
Went right past her defender and never slowed down. And, man, I tell you what, all of the momentum was over here on this Lady Vikings sideline. But that right there, going in there, around their best player, straight to the hoop, that'll bring them down a little bit, and it did. It got a lot quieter right after that.
Well, when she's playing basketball, she's not just shooting the threes at Six Flags.
Sure, right.
You know, looking for a basketball to take home.
Yeah.
So credited to the Lady Farmers. Keep doing what you're doing. Don't keep checking the scoreboard.
Stay consistent.
Stay consistent.
Yep, I agree. So 5-point lead here for the Lady Farmers. The Vikings will have the ball coming out of the timeout. Spencer is their hot girl right now, who's made two threes the last two times down. But again, they're keeping the ball out of Jingle's hand. She's the one that really worries me the most on offense. And they're doing a really good job of denying her the ball. So if we can, and you and I said this a bunch tonight, Nelson, they've got to continue to block out and just give them one shot.
Yeah, give them one shot. The multiple opportunities down low. That's what it does. Also, if we don't have the ball, it gives us an opportunity to foul, and we can't do that.
And look at the scoreboard.
It's 4-0 on fouls.
Yeah, we got four already this quarter because of that. So, Blankenship definitely feeling better after a really ugly spill there in the second quarter.
She's really fought through and played.
Oh, man. And gutsy performance here. She's going to be manned up against Jingles and trying to deny her the ball.
Jingles with a little push off there.
Yeah. Over to Jones. She steps up for the three. Way off. Nice job there by McCray. Comes away with it.
There's 4 minutes. We have the lead. We need to retain it.
Yep, I agree. Got to play smart basketball here. Make good passes. No turnovers.
Don't force it. There's no shot clock.
Yep.
Work through. Let the play develop.
Lady Farmers being really deliberate here on offense, just looking for a good shot.
Miss McCray down low there.
Nice. Nice screen there by Purser.
I thought she dissed it off.
I did too.
As she was almost jump stopping base.
Empty possession there for the Lady Farmers, but it did take 30 seconds off. Nice job there by Blankenship. Hernandez coming over trying to help.
Yeah, she don't want to get into too much trouble.
Nice. Good job there by McCray of knocking that one away. Oh, they're going to call it a foul. Golly, and this is one of those where now they're in the double bonus, and so they're going to get free throws from here on out, but she hit the ball. That's a bad call.
Wow.
It's an easy call to make, but it's a bad call. First free throw's up and off. Got to block out here. Can't give them any second chances.
Number 10 and number 0 coming in for the Lady Vikings.
Knight and Crawford coming in.
So, Spencer's going to.
That's weird. They're going to put Spencer in. Maybe they're playing offense defense here and she's trying to get better defenders in. I'm not sure, but I sure want to take Spencer out. Second free throw rattles home. Makes it a 4-point lead here for the Lady Farmers. Under 3.5 to play in the game. Nice ball handling here by Hernandez.
Yeah, she's a great dribbler.
Goes to McCray. McCray goes straight to the hoop. Not able to finish, but it
are
is.
Are we going
to
get?
Finally get a foul.
We get a shooting foul.
You can see the Farmer faithful over there finally. That's a pretty sarcastic cheer as they're excited that we finally get a call here.
I clapped.
Yeah. So first foul he's called on us in 5 minutes here in this. Called on them, I'm sorry, against us. Free throw off just a little bit there for McCray.
Just throw it off the front of the rim, grab it, and dunk it.
Just like you did in seventh grade, huh?
Absolutely, man. They call me Space Jam.
Mm-hmm. Second one up. No good, but Purser. Great job by Purser.
Throws off Tim's face.
Off of the face of Knight. That didn't feel good from that close. She's tough. She popped up and said she's okay, but I bet that hurt.
She didn't expect that, obviously, but nothing intentional at the same time. Just
Jones is going to check in for her. Pearson back in. 3:06 here for the Lady Farmers to play. Gets it out to Hernandez. Got a screen by McCray. Back to McCray. Nice take. Just lost control there. Good job by Purser. Goes to McCray on the pass. Oh, my goodness. That's a walk.
Oh, yes. I thought he was going to call a jump ball.
No, she went backwards. Lady Farmers, benefit of a call. Okay,
I guess
so, yeah,
confusion.
You and I were both trying to figure out what was going on. I couldn't even tell the crowd because I didn't know. So, but it looks like
Vikings called a timeout.
Trying to call a timeout here, and everyone was wondering if they were going to get the timeout or not. And then I guess this other guy walking away might be the head referee because it seems like he's the one that's kind of in the middle of everything. But as it is, it's going to be a little over 2 minutes to play when this ball is inbounded. Farmersville will be throwing it in. And trying to get this four-point lead home. It's been a surprisingly decent offensive showing here for Pinkston,
sure,
because they missed so many threes in that first half.
In the first half.
And they've started. It's been, again, you live by the three and you die by the three. So, Lady Farmers really, if they rebound, they play good defense and rebound, I think they've got a chance to pull this one out. Just can't give them too many chances. Blankenship will be throwing this one in for the Lady Farmers as the Vikings come out of the timeout and run down to play defense. Oh, nice inbounds play there. McCray cuts in and able to.
She's been really good in the block tonight.
Able to make that little layup there. Just caught everybody off guard. Extended out to a six-point lead as Jingles got a couple of steps there. Had a few hands reach in. That's on Blankenship. Yeah, I think that's only her first or second, isn't it?
Second, yeah.
Yeah. But it does put Jingle at the free throw line. 2.5 minutes to play. First free throw up and no good.
Going to give a shout out to my little man Miles at home.
He's going to be a baller.
We get that baseball. I already told Coach Quinlan he'd be QB1 in like 2036. They're at home
Jingles
tuning in, watching tonight. So we appreciate all you guys tuning in tonight as we approach 2.5 minutes left here in the ball game as your Lady Farmers
nice
lead.
Nice job by Hernandez. Purser back to Hernandez. Puts it on the floor once. Oh, doesn't get it. Fetty comes away with it. Going to reset here. Nice job there by the Farmers.
There's no shot clock. Take
running that one down. Absolutely. Yeah, so they're going to make them come out and put a little pressure on them. Uh-oh. McCray picked up her dribble. Knocked away. Oh. Going to say that one went off of Purser. 2:07 to play. 5-point lead for the Farmers. Again. Blankenship trying to deny that inbounds pass to Jingles. Jones brings it up, thought about the three, hands it off to Jingles as they make the two-minute announcement here. Oh, nice job by Blankenship knocking it away. Now they're going to get in there and tie it up. Oh, they're going to say that she called a timeout before Farmersville was able to get their hands on the ball, so that saves a possession for them, but I don't know that she got that timeout made in time.
Yeah,
as it is, they only have two left. Farmersville has three. They are the double bonus here. 5-point lead. But, yeah, this has been a really hectic last 3 or 4 minutes.
Yeah, you know, thankfully for the 16-point lead at half.
Yeah.
You know, or this will be a little bit different swing
of
a ball game.
Yeah, there's no doubt of that for sure. Well, and the one thing I'll say about both teams, and the Lady Farmers especially, but Pinkston as well, I mean, they've been playing. How many times have we seen girls on the ground fighting for the ball? And I mean, like, they've both been really playing hard and going after it. Lady Farmers, 5-point lead. I mean, they've done it a little bit more, and they're going to have to continue to do it for the next 2 minutes.
Got a good group of farmer athletes over there cheering on the Lady Farmers tonight.
The Purple Pack.
Look to be about 25 or 30 over there, make the drive to Rowlett tonight. So, you know, and that just, we're not a huge 6A school, but the support that these kids have for each other.
Completely agree, yeah.
In sports or, you know, different events or band or cheer or whatever the case may be, you know, it just,
yep,
they're all there cheering both sides. So that's good to see on a school night nonetheless.
Completely agree.
And it'd just be a great feat as we just under 2 minutes here, we come back from this timeout, to see them advance to the next round, you know, for Coach Hogue's program here.
That
so
would be awesome. So Jingles will be inbounding the ball. 1:53 to play. Vikings run a little motion here, looking for somewhere to go. Barely gets it in time. Pearson swings it around tonight. She's got the open three, but she steps inside of it. Little runner is off. McCray fights to the floor on that one. They're going to say that it went out of McCray. Man, okay.
My mom said if you can't say anything nice, don't say anything at all.
Might be awfully quiet for a little while. Jingles, bounce pass in. Goes a little hard on that one. Nice job by McCray. I'm coming away
Where's
with it.
Where's the foul?
Oh, Purser goes up.
But we're going to call that.
Golly. Man, this.
They're trying to give the game away.
This is really bad.
McGee couldn't, or McCray couldn't get a step in edgewise when she had the rebound.
Down. Yeah, she got knocked off of her feet. Man.
And every foul that we get, they go to the line.
First free throw, air ball.
Mm.
That's tough.
Purple pack lets them know about it.
That's a tough one. Well, as I say, the ball don't lie, right?
It was nothing but net.
Yeah. Clemens checking in for Knight and Crawford checking in for Spencer. Again, taking your one of your hot ones out.
Other than Jingles, those two have shot the most tonight.
I think just trying to get their better defenders in is all I can think of.
Possibly,
I'm not
you
sure.
Don't.
Nice job by McCray. Comes away with that one. Outlet pass to Purser. Yeah. Slow it down here. No need to be in a hurry. Going to need some help, though. Coach Hogue calls a timeout because they were having a hard time beating that 10-second clock.
Yeah.
But heads-up play by Coach Hogue. It's going to be a 20. So she'll still have some full timeouts left. So a minute and 24 to play here. Your Lady Farmers, five-point lead. Looking to put some points on the board right here. You got to really feel – you know, a lot better about your chances. But also, you want to take some time off the clock. You don't want to force anything. You don't want to force any, you know, risky passes or anything like that. But if you can give yourself a really good look and take some time off the clock, that'd be ideal.
Good thing the camera is not on us as you're dancing up here in the booth.
Yeah.
I know this brings back prom of, what, 93?
Oh, man, and four. Yeah, 93 and 94. I think ours was a little more Belle Biv DeVoe, though.
Belle Biv DeVoe?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man, yeah, a little Poison.
A little BBD.
Yeah.
Finally get the ball in. Hernandez, oh, good pass there. It's Kelly checks in for the first time. Another ball handler in there with
fresh
Hernandez.
Legs, fresh lungs as we approach the final minute here in the fourth.
Yeah, they're playing a little keep away right now is what they're doing. I like it.
Why
back
not?
To Hernandez. Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, that's a
thank
foul.
You.
Yep. You haven't called that all half.
And that's why you do it. That's the fourth foul on Jingles.
Oh, no, that would be a.
That would be a huge loss.
Yes.
For the Vikings. And it looks like Lady Farmers are going to go back to their little stall offense here. Oh,
just over Rindy's touch.
Rindy might have jumped a little too soon on that one. As it was, though, they were able to take 24 seconds off the clock. Back down to a minute here.
McCray back in
for Kelly. Kelly doing a good – brought in another ball handler there. I remember last year calling a game when she scored 20-something, almost 30 points. So someone's got some experience and did a good job out there of making the Vikings foul. Oh, nice
job. Great
job
by Fetty. She knocks the ball out.
Goes back to Hernandez. Jingle on her. She can't foul her because she'll be gone. Lady Farmer's doing a good job of keeping the ball away. Blankenship had an open three. Nice job. Spencer fouls. That'll be the second of the third team foul this quarter. 37 seconds to play. Lady Farmer still with possession.
Kelly back in for McCray there. Going to bring out Jingles here. 37 seconds left. I mean, she's
– Well, because
they're
going to
foul situation.
Foul, right.
Yes.
They're going to have to foul. So
almost immediately, I would say, Brian. I mean, there's 37
you
seconds.
You have to. Yeah.
You've got two or a foul to give. I mean, you need – like
yeah,
even the crowd is saying fouler.
Yes. Yeah, they're yelling at him to foul.
I mean, that took off 6 seconds, and you could have done that in .6 as soon as the ball was thrown in.
For sure. So they're going to do this one more time, put Lady Farmers at the free throw line, see if they can't rebound it, but
yeah,
definitely playing in Lady Farmers' hands right now. Good job by Hernandez, been able to get open. Goes back over to Kelly. And call another foul on Jones. So you know, Kelly at the free throw line.
That was the weakest foul I've seen all night. I know the situation. The referees are looking for it.
I agree.
We have had Matthews and McGee and McRae fall face first and Purser getting hit in the head and not get a foul called. How do you change the direction of a human's body without touching them?
And that one right there, she barely –
I know they were looking for the touch, the foul, to get them to the foul trouble, but at the same time
– it's annoying.
It is.
Kelly not able to get that first one to go, but now, she will get another one.
I will say I'm going to be biased for a moment. The Lady Farmers had ample opportunity on the shots or rebounds to get those points and not have to be worried about the last 30 seconds of a game with a five-point lead. But nonetheless, that is where we are with 27 seconds as Kelly shoots her second shot and knocks it down to extend the lead to 6.
McCray comes back in, play a little defense here. 6-point lead, 26.9 seconds to play.
This Blankenship is all over Jingles as she comes back in. She gets the lob pass.
Hernandez came across to help. Jingles pull up 3, knocks it down. Wow. Makes it a 3-point game. As Pinkston uses their last timeout.
20 seconds on the dot remaining.
Wow, that was a huge shot.
There's no reason to let that shot go. I would have almost not fouled her at the 3-point line,
but
fouled her before she took a shot, maybe? Yeah. Sent her to the line to shoot to?
It's a tough one, man. It's a tough one because, again, they have made a lot more in the second half than they have in the game, but, God, we've seen them miss so many that, that's a tough spot to be in. But Lady Farmers are going to have the ball, 3-point lead, and they are in the bonus now. And so what you want to do is play keep away, which they did a great job of doing earlier. And then if you do go to the free throw line, you got to make at least one.
And, again, I know this is – I'm thinking, not proactively, but a 3 only ties the game if we were to somehow not score, get fouled and knock a free throw down. They get the rebound and do what Jingles just did.
Which means you don't need to press here, right? Don't take an ill-advised shot. Yeah. And let's see if they run the little – see what Blankenship goes deep here on the snowbird. They've done this twice tonight, and it's been open both times.
Well, you've got Hernandez up here, and you don't have McRae where Kelly's in for McRae.
But watch this. See if they do it. Yep, they did. They did it again. And there's a lot of time. Good job by Rindy of taking her time there.
Sure. You've got 10 seconds to get across the court, and there's a body on Kelly there.
Yep. And guess what? Jingles, that's her 5th.
But she had to.
Yeah.
In order to have the possibility of possession returned, she had to foul and not say, hey, teammate, come foul because you've only got 2.
Yeah, and that's obviously a big loss for Pinkston, but only option they have at the time. If Kelly makes one of these right here, makes it a 2-possession game.
And that should solidify the win for your Lady Farmers here in the first round, which – you know, not going to count the eggs before they hatch.
Yeah, I was going to say, let's see what happens. But no, it does make you feel a whole lot more comfortable, for sure. And now you're just going to have to keep an eye there on Spencer.
As number 0, Crawford comes in for the fouled out Jingles.
Kelly puts it up. A little strong on the first one there. Hernandez goes up, talks to her. A couple of more substitutions here as Knight and Jones come back in.
Some displeased fans on the Viking side towards the Viking coaches. As there's your 4-point lead.
I think, there's going to be a substitution there as McCray comes back in. Hey, great job there by Ashton Kelly, who came in this fourth quarter, hadn't
been cold on the bench all game, comes in and able to knock down a couple free throws tonight.
Yeah, and does a really and done a good job of playing
Hernandez
keep away there.
Does not need to foul.
Knight puts up the 3 off. Purser comes away with it. And that is going to be a first round win for your Lady Farmers.
Great job, Lady Farmers.
They beat the Lady Vikings of Pinkston 40-36.
And it's not how they start, it's how they finish. They fought through some missed foul calls. You know, it took forever. It took to the last 3 minutes for them to get into the bonus against Pinkston. And, you know, they fought through that. They fought through an injury from Blankenship as Coach Harold Davis walks out on the court with the first-round playoff trophy. For your Lady Farmers, I don't know when this has happened before.
I'm really happy for Coach Hogue. Those girls, they played a hard game. They hustled all night long. Put up some, again, there was a lot of frustration and emotions out there because of some of the calls that weren't going their way. And they fought through that and able to get the W. So as we get a little bit more information from Mr. G about the next game, it's going to be Friday. We're not sure where or who yet. But when we have any information that we can share, if you guys continue to keep up with us on social media, on Facebook, we'll make sure that we share that information and get the live stream link out there to you guys. So until then, thanks again tonight.
Look at that purple pack behind our girls.
I love it. Thanks again for joining us tonight, and we'll join you guys at the next round and the area round. So,
Brian, appreciate doing this with you, man. That was a good game.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun, man. Yeah. Hopefully we can do it again. So,
shout out to Mr. G and his crew, or I guess Mr. G and Mr. B. That is the crew.
The whole crew.
And Farmersville ISD for providing the live stream that you guys can tune in. So
it's awesome.
Yeah. Go Farmers.
Congratulations, Lady Farmers, and we will see you guys on Friday. Until then, as always, go Farmers.